Welcome back to another video. This video is another teaching video on all of the things that I think you need as a teacher from Dollar Tree. So if you are new here, my name is Crystal. I just finished up my second year teaching first grade, and I am going to be a third year teacher. But these are the things that I think that every teacher needs from Dollar Tree. Dollar Tree is so great because it's affordable. So if you need to repurchase something because it was messed up or broken in your classroom, then it's really easy to get another one. So we are going to start off with some things. So as you know, I am on summer vacation right now, and I don't have all of these items with me right now. I was able to pick up a few of them, but most of them are in my classroom. So I'm gonna show a little picture off to the side of the item if I do not have it with me. First, I am going to start off with all of the storage needs that you can use in your classroom. So I'm going to start with the thing that I think all teachers need. If you see it, you have to get it. They're really hard to find. And these are called the plastic snack containers. And I actually have one with me right now. I bought a ton of these my first year teaching in several different colors. And I have one right now in green because if you saw my classroom tour video, my classroom is a leaf theme. It's almost like a jungle theme, kind of island theme. So I thought that I would keep the green ones and then get rid of all the other ones. So I did. And I stocked up on some more that you will see in my haul that should be coming very soon. But these hold things perfectly. These hold a deck of cards perfectly. They hold, I used to put dice in here, and then they also hold math manipulatives very well. They hold a pack of crayons perfectly. So this is a really nice versatile product, and sometimes they come in a pack of two, and sometimes they come in a pack of three. So they're super, super affordable and really sturdy as well. All right, the next storage item that I think you need. These I used both years, my first and second year, but I had them in black my first year, and now this past year I had them in white because they go with my room more. But these are the three compartment plastic caddies, and these are really, really nice. They are very sturdy. Some people don't like that they have the holes in them, but I don't really mind. And for the big part of the caddy, I have them store their pencils, whiteboard markers, and erasers, and this is for the whole team. I put one on in the middle of each team. And then in the small part, I have them store their dry erase erasers that are just wristbands, athletic wristbands. And then for the middle compartment, the one that's the middle size, I have them store their crayons in there, and they just share. Obviously, this upcoming school year, probably not going to use that because they're going to have their own personal bins, but yeah, I love these for my team caddies. For my next item, I love these plastic buckets with handles. They come in a 3-pack, and I use these my first year. I actually didn't use them this past year, but I use these for storing my pencils. My dull pencils were one cup, and then I had my sharp pencils in the other cup. I labeled them really easy, and then the other extra, I don't remember what I did with it, but you can always use another storage container in your classroom. And for the next one, I think every teacher needs is this plastic bags. These plastic baskets, they're rectangular. They have one here with me today. that I was able to take from my classroom. This looks like this, and I use these for my math stations. I have, or math manipulatives and the math stations. I have all the manipulatives that they need for the day in here, and then they're stored in my math cart. And then whenever they need them, whenever we do math, then the team leader gets one for their team, and then they put it on their table, and then they all share and put it back when they need it. And these are super affordable as well because they come in a 3-pack. They are super nice. The only thing is sometimes things like the red and yellow counters might slip out from them, but usually that's not a big deal. The next item that I have are these popcorn tubs, and these are super nice for class parties. I used to have a lot of class parties, way too many, my first year of teaching, and we would have popcorn parties, and so I would use these bins along with the skinnier ones, and then the teams would share. Obviously, I wouldn't be doing that for the upcoming year, but that is really a really cute idea. You can also fill this bucket in with snacks, and if you ever need to make a gift bag for school events, then this is a really cute way to store them. Another item that I think all teachers need are these dry erase plastic locker bins, and I have one with me right now as well that's holding all my things. But it looks like this. Of course, I have it in white to match my classroom, but these are really nice to store library books. These are really common for storing books for your classroom library. They're dry erase, so you can write on them and then erase it really easily. And they are only $1, so they are super affordable. Another item that is really helpful in the classroom are these plastic storage tubs with handles. And these are really, really big. If I had one, I would show you, but they're a pretty big size. They can hold lunch pails and bigger items, maybe reading buddies, but what I use them to store in my classroom are the headphones. So I'd have one for headphones, my class set, as well as the kids' personal headphones. And then the second one would have all the Chromebook chargers and cables, because I did not have a Chromebook cart in my classroom this year, so I used one of these buckets to hold them. The next item are these Teaching Tree colorful plastic book bins, and I use these my first year of teaching. They are super, super nice. I use them in the blue color, if you saw in my very first classroom tour. And they use them to store their books, their library books, their small group reading books, and their writing notebooks. A whole bunch of things fit in this book bin. You can label them with a vinyl if you would like, but they are super, super affordable. Usually book bins are about $3, so this is the way to go if you find them in your color. Now I am moving on to more of the office supplies and little things like that. So I think that teachers definitely need to pick up these plastic button magnets. I used these my first year of teaching. I had my behavior chart on this file cabinet, and so all the magnets I labeled, I just wrote their number in Sharpie, I believe, that year, but I had them labeled with their number, and then they could move their number whenever they moved up or moved down on the behavior chart. And I actually did this past year as well, but I used the Daiso magnets, and they're literally the same thing, but these are super, super sturdy, and they lasted all my first year of teaching. And yeah, these are super nice, and they come, I'm not sure how many they come in a pack, but it says 6 packs and 4 pack, 6 count and 4 count packs, depending on if they're small or big, but it's super affordable. Next, I recommend these erasers. They come in a 40 pack, and for me, at least in first grade, the pencil eraser tops get worn down so quick. And so having these eraser tops make it so helpful for the students to have an eraser. And I also use them in my reward system so that they can just choose their own color whenever they wanted a new one, and this was super nice to have. I also recommend these clear push pins. Now I use the colored ones. Last year I used the clear ones because I was trying to go more with my classroom theme, but all the push pins are super nice. You won't get them cheaper than $1, and they come in 120 count, and you use them all the time in your classroom, especially in the beginning of the school year. So this is really nice to have, and I store mine in my teacher toolbox. Another type of push pins are these push pins with hooks on the bottom, and these I found out later on this past year, but these are really nice to have. I hang a lot of things on the walls, so instead of having to make the little clothespin with the push pin gluing the push pin on the back, you can just buy these, and they come in a 40 count. These are super versatile, and you can use them for anything, maybe holding up anchor charts and things like that. Next, I am going to be showing you some things that the students can use, and it's nice to have in your classroom for your students. So first, I have these metal serving trays, and they come in a rectangular shape and an oval shape. And these are really nice if you have magnet letters. So these are really nice for them to use those magnetic letters or magnetic whatever and put it on these trays if you don't have a dry erase board that's magnetic for them to use. And these are super sturdy. They are really nice quality, and it's very surprising for them to be at the Dollar Tree, but they are so cute, so sturdy, and really fun for them to use. I have a couple more items. The next thing that I think teachers should buy from Dollar Tree for their students are these dice, and these come in a 10 pack at Dollar Tree, which is super affordable again. And these I bought multiple times, my first year, my second year, just whenever I need them. The great thing is that we use these for everything. They use them for reading station, math stations, roll and read, adding, subtracting, everything like that in first grade. And I use these in conjunction with these containers, and these come as in a 10 pack as well, so you can buy a 10 pack of the dice and then a 10 pack of these containers. They come in this shape or the rectangular shape, but I like this one more for the purpose that is they put these inside, or they don't put them inside because they're already in there. They're closed like this, and all they have to do whenever they need to roll a dice is they shake it, and this is so nice. I started this my very first year of teaching, and I've gotten so many compliments on this ever since whenever teachers see it. But you don't have dice flying around. I don't even have to buy dice because I rarely have my students lose these, or they rarely lose these dice because they're in this container. I have seen teachers put a piece of foam on the bottom so that when they shake them, they're not that loud. Honestly, it's not too loud for me, and usually I only have 5 to 6 students doing this at a time in the classroom because they're at a station. So this is a really nice hack from Dollar Tree. Next, I also use these in my math stations. I recommend these playing cards, and they come in a 2-pack. For this, I like to use these in math, obviously, but in first grade, I have to teach them, obviously, what the ace is, like what number it is, and the jack and the queen and the king, obviously. But this is also super affordable as well. And for these deck of cards specifically, I also use them in these containers. I actually have pink ones and I have blue ones. So the playing cards come in red and blue in a pack, so the pink ones go in a pink container, or the red ones go in a pink container, and then the blue ones go in the blue container, and it helps the students make sure that they put them in the right container, and it helps with not mixing them up with other groups that are beside them. I have two more items, and the first one are these adhesive label holders. They look like this, and I use this one, obviously. These are really nice to label things in the classroom, to label book bins, to label binders, and they come in an 18-pack, so they're super, super nice, and they stick very well. And the last thing that I recommend for teachers to buy from Dollar Tree are these huge popsicle sticks. These popsicle sticks, they come more in a pack, but these are the giant ones. And how I use these are, you can see right there, I just have the student numbers right here, and this is the way that I can randomly call on my students. You can also use popsicle sticks for stem bins. You can put pieces of Velcro on the tips and on both sides, and then they can stick them together and make different creations. So that is everything that I recommend all teachers buy from Dollar Tree. It is so affordable, so if you need to stock up on anything, it won't hurt your wallet. And Dollar Tree has so many amazing things, so I recommend that you stop by there and pick up a few things, especially those little containers, the snack containers that look like this, because these are super hard to find. So yeah. That is everything. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching, and I have some classroom hauls coming up soon, as well as some DIYs that I want to do for my classroom, so I hope you stay tuned for that. Again, thank you for watching, and bye!